Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and we wanted to talk about rain barrels and using the water that runs off of your roof into your garden as best you can. We're just at the beginning of experimenting with this ourselves. We had an old, it was a brand new fertilizer tank that we bought 1 year to house our fish over winter. We got it at Farm and Fleet, or Fleet and Farm, and used it for many years downstairs, brought our fish in from the pond each winter, and would keep them until the following spring and then put them back out again. Eventually we decided that was just way too much work for us. So we've had this barrel sitting here in the garden, planning on using it at some time. Well, our son Sky decided it was a waste to just have it sitting here. He set up buckets under our drain spouts in the front of the house, and every time it would rain, he would faithfully come, empty the buckets into the tank, and then I would use my little pitcher, turn the spigot, and the water would come out. The problem being that the setup that we have is like a reverse hose from your house. The wrong end is available, and we kept saying, well, yeah, we'll go to the hardware store and get the right part. Well, we never did. So it came upon me, turn the hose around, use the small end of the hose, attach it, and use it to water the garden.
Well, you're actually using the male end of the hose and hooking it into the female.
Yes.
Connector off right. The spigot.
And there's not that much pressure that the water that comes out the other end needs
gravity
to be regulated.
Yeah,
it doesn't need to be regulated with a sprayer, so I can just move it. It gently just floods the area and does a great job. And put some mosquito netting over the top so we're not growing mosquitoes. I know there were some in here before I put the net on. They're not going to be able to get out now.
Well, not only mosquitoes, but also leaf and debris and
True.
Other things
Something that
could fall in the tank and clog it.
Clog up my drain system. So this is our experiment so far. Eventually, we would like to hook it up off of the garage roof and collect that rainwater, maybe in a different tank, so we have two tanks going. But for right now, this is it. It's working well. It's supposed to rain this afternoon and tonight, so we may get it filled up again.
Actually, I can reposition this tank closer to one of the downspouts, and the hose will still work gravity fed once you get it running. So, you know, we'll experiment, and it's just a matter
experiment.
Of where to place it and how to get the rain gutters to work, because right now our nearest rain gutter over here is really off the back screen porch, and the height of that really isn't, you know, that tall, but
that might be perfect just to cut it off.
Maybe, but then we'd have to stick it in such a place where it could be blocking the walkway, and I don't want to do that, so we'll just have to come up with a creative solution.
That's
maybe
right.
An archway or something.
Ooh, that'd be interesting. But like we said, we experiment, we try things. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. Sometimes it takes us a long time to get to it, but What we're using is working, as long as we still have Sky and all of his muscles to do it for us.
And being that this is the last day of July, we do have a bunch of raspberry canes for anybody in the local area who would like some. Just give us a call. Come on over. We've got a big bucket. Probably there's, what, maybe 50 canes
in
there?
And I need that bucket for my rain collection.
Yes. So if you're local and want to stop by and pick up some free, delicious raspberry canes, they're bare-rooted right now, but
right.
They're in water, and they're doing really
they
well.
And they will be producing fruit next year.
Yep. This so. Would be a good time to get them in the ground.
Mm-hmm.
So,
thanks for watching. Give us a thumbs up if you have time. We'd love to hear from you. Please subscribe.
So, our next mission is to start going out and see what we can find locally for some rain barrels, and maybe we'll find something on sale as
Before
it's getting closer
season.
To the end here.
That's
so
right.
Be ready for next year.
Here's a weed. I have to pull it.
Oh, yes. never-ending task.
Oh, now this is a question I would have anybody that might know.
It's like a clover.
What is this weed? It is so prolific. I'm trying to see if it has the nodules on it like clover do, but I'm not seeing any. It has yellow blossoms on it. Right there is a yellow blossom. It can grow this tall if you let it.
Yeah, cut several feet.
And you can, I mean, it's edible. It's like a clover. You can chew on it, and it tastes a little bit lemony. If anybody knows, I'd love to know what this is.
We probably have a million of them growing on our property.
Oh, at least.
I tell you, I cannot look any place without pulling these things out. They're
and
all
they,
over.
They come out easily. I mean, it isn't like they're horrible. They're not like a thistle where you have to actually dig them out. They come out quite easily. They don't have prickers on them. They decompose quickly, but they are prolific.
They sure are. Boy, we could start a crop of that. I think somebody could make a lot of money.
We could bale it.
Yeah, there you go.
Feed it to the dogs. If you learned something, enjoyed the video, please give us a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and we'd love to hear from you and have you subscribe.
And I also want to thank people for being so patient, because so many questions have been rolling in this year. I know that you're doing your best at night when you're not in the garden, and we haven't had much rain.
No.
But I know you've been trying to get back to every single person and at least replying to them. So again, please be patient. I think you're probably up to about 425,000 people now who have viewed,
thank
and
you.
Thousands of subscribers now who are sending in their questions. So
And tips.
Yeah.
I'm learning a lot. So.
Yeah. Well, again, you know, for those of you who maybe are just watching our video for the very first time, please understand that we're experimenting here in the garden, and basically this is a daily blog of what we're doing. Not that we're experts in things. I mean, we've had a lot of experience, obviously, or at least I should say you have in the garden, and me watching you and videotaping you. But this is a blog. This is something we're just simply showing people what you're doing on a daily basis, kind of. And you know, yes, we have other videos related to this one and hundreds of them now, but, you know.
Each year you find something new or somebody will suggest something or you will read about it, and we thought, well, let's give that a try.